Zero Kazama. This is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Berga. Dan. Michael. Milton. Pascal. And Jamal. Six fraternity brothers, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each challenge is worth $300. Now remember, silence. Begin.
The contestant must brush his teeth with spicy wasabi paste for 30 seconds.
I guess that's acceptable.
Michael's terrible aftertaste was worth it. The guys are off to a good start, earning $300. The contestant must allow chickens to eat off his feet for 30 seconds.
Acceptable.
It wasn't pleasant, but Dan let the chickens do their thing. The team is two for two, and they now have $600.
Thank you.
The contestant must withstand the force of an exploding balloon.
Too noisy. You lose.
The explosive laughter deflates the team, and the guys suffer their first loss of the day. Their total remains at $600. Up next, Berga gets smacked, and Milton meets an overly friendly old man. When Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. The guys have been through a lot already, and they've got $600 to show for it. Don't forget, everyone must remain quiet, and they're playing together as a team.
Round two. Each challenge is now worth $400. But remember the most important rule. Silence. Continue.
The contestant must have his suspenders snapped by a teammate.
I'll accept that.
Berga's pain is the team's gain. The guys are now up to $1,000. The contestant must chew a mouthful of bitter horseradish for 20 seconds.
I'll give you that one.
Milton took his bite like a champ, and the team ups its total, which now stands at $1,400.
Oh.
The contestant must endure an old man's unusual greeting for 20 seconds. Milton's short nightmare is over, and the team benefits. After a perfect second round, their total now stands at $1,800. Still to come, things get hairy for Milton, and Dan makes crappy pottery when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. Today's team has endured pain, discomfort, and embarrassment. And so far, it's been worth it. They've won $1,800 up to this point. Don't forget, whoever draws the skull and crossbones gets punished. And everyone must stay quiet for the team to win.
Round three. Each challenge is now worth double, $800. And above all, silence. Round three.
The contestant must sculpt fresh elephant dung into a vase.
I guess that's acceptable.
Dan's dung pottery passes the test, and the team earns another $800, putting their total at $2,600. The contestant has 15 seconds to eat a cupcake topped with ketchup, relish, mayo, barbecue sauce, mustard, or ranch dip.
Oh.
did not succeed.
The team made too much noise, and Jamal didn't finish in time. The total remains at $2,600. The contestant must have a stranger's beard transferred onto his own face.
I'll give you that one.
Milton's temporary beard pushes the team over $3,000 for the day. Their total now stands at $3,400. Coming up, Pascal feels pain he hasn't felt since grade school when Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. The team has had quite a day. They've already won $3,400, but the stakes are now higher than ever. This next challenge could raise their winnings to $4,400 if they play their cards right. As always, the skull and crossbones means you're getting punished, and everyone must stay quiet.
Final round. The challenge is worth $1,000, but do not forget, silence. Resume play.
The contestant must receive the most atomic of wedgies.
Fine, the money's yours.
Pascal's wardrobe malfunction pays off. The team has won the final challenge of the day, worth $1,000, for a grand total of $4,400. Congratulations, guys! You've survived Silent Library. and you won some cash, $734 per player. Not bad for a day at the library. Go to silentlibrary.mtv.com to check out outrageous clips from the show, view photos, and more.
I'm Zero Kazama. This is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Kurt, Max, Simon, Brian, Andrew, and Ben. Six bandmates, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each of these challenges are worth $300. But don't forget, silence. Begin.
The contestant must be slapped with a fish for 20 seconds.
Worthwhile. You get the money.
It wasn't pretty, but Simon gets the team going with $300. The contestant must clean the bottom of a dirty boot with his tongue for 30 seconds.
Accept that.
Brian took one for the team, keeping their perfect start intact. They double their winnings and now have $600. The contestant must do the limbo back and forth using the gymnast as a bar. Brian couldn't clear the crotch, and round one ends with a loss. The team's winnings remain at $600. Up next, Kurt gets a lesson in ice fishing, and Brian crashes and burns. When Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. The team won the first two challenges, but lost the third, ending round one with $600 to show for their pain and suffering. Remember, the skull and crossbones equals punishment, and they're playing as a team.
Round two. The challenges are now worth $400 each. And don't forget, silence. Resume play.
The contestant must take a short ride in a dangerous car.
You survived the challenge. You win the money.
Brian's car crash is worth another $400. They now have $1,000 as their total. The contestant has 30 seconds to eat a snow cone topped with fish sauce.
Through all of that for nothing.
Kurt couldn't stomach the fish, and his team suffers the consequences. Their total stays put at $1,000. Still to come, Simon gets ripped, and Ben gets baked. When Silent Library continues. We're back with more Silent Library. The team has already endured much embarrassment and discomfort, and the day is just warming up. So far, the guys have $1,000. Remember, they're working together as a team, and everyone must keep their voices down.
Round three. The challenges are now worth double, $800. Remember, silence. Resume play.
The contestant must have his happy trail plucked by a professional.
Your patience has been rewarded.
Round three is off to a good start as Andrew's threading earns the guys another $800, putting their total at $1,800. The contestant must be blasted with muffins.
You have emerged victorious.
Ben survived the pastry shooting, and his team adds another $800 to their total, which now stands at $2,600. The contestant must have 30 clothespins attached and then ripped off his body.
Your bravery has served you well. You pass.
Simon helps the team complete a perfect third round. Their winnings are at $3,400. Coming up, Ben meets his match. When Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. After a perfect round three, the guys have $3,400 as their total. But a strong final round could bring in another $1,000. As always, the team must stay quiet, and the skull and crossbones means somebody's getting punished.
Final round. One challenge worth $1,000. But keep in mind, silence. Continue.
The contestant must withstand an attack by a wrestler.
I see no reason to punish you further. You win.
Ben's pain gives the team its biggest win of the day. $1,000 is added for a total of $4,400. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library and you won some cash. $734 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
Kazama, this is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Emmanuel. Steve. Nick. Olaf. Corey and Ben. Six friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each of these challenges are worth $300. But do not forget, silence. Begin.
The contestant must pop a series of balloons while wearing vampire teeth.
Can't deny you that one.
Emmanuel bites his way to $300. The team is off and running. The contestant must have his underarm hair plucked.
Discomfort had purpose. You get the money.
Oleaf put up with the pain, so the team adds another $300. They're now at $600 for the day. The contestant must unlock a woman's top.
Excitement. You fail.
Oleaf got smacked for nothing. The guys couldn't keep their voices down, so they end round one with 600 big ones. Up next, Nick gets suspended, and Oleaf gets held back. When Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. The guys were rolling right along until a beautiful woman stopped them in their tracks. They won two out of the first three challenges. Good for $600. Remember, the player who gets the skull and crossbones gets punished, and everyone must remain as quiet as possible.
Round two. Each challenge is worth more. $400. But do not forget. Silence. Resume play.
The contestant must keep water and a teaspoon of crushed Alka-Seltzer in his mouth for 30 seconds.
Oh,
A valiant effort, but no money.
Ben couldn't contain himself, so the guys lose their second straight challenge. Their total stands at $600. While being held back by rubber bands, the contestant must catch 5 dangling chocolates in 30 seconds.
Impressive. You pass.
O'Leaf used his head and downed the chocolates. The team wins $400 for a total of $1,000. The contestant must have his suspenders snapped by a teammate.
Team's gain.
Nick's ordeal makes it 2 in a row for the guys. They add another $400 as their total climbs to $1,400. Still to come, Corey gets swatted and feels the heat of the meat when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. Today's team has really earned their money, getting slapped, snapped, and squeezed along the way. So far, they have $1,400 to show for it. Remember, one contestant is punished for drawing the wrong card, and the guys are playing together for the cash.
Round 3. The money has doubled. Each challenge is now worth $800. But you must not forget. Silence. Continue.
The contestant must be smacked repeatedly with giant fly swatters for 20 seconds. Thank you.
Yo, turn the back of his neck.
Pain, humiliation, and success.
Corey got swatted, and his team gets paid. That was worth $800, making the current total $2,200. The contestant must go back and forth through a gyro meat wash, head first.
Oh, look at this grip.
You survived the punishment and won the money.
Corey's meat squeeze wraps up a perfect third round. Another $800 is added, putting their winnings at $3,000. Coming up, Ben meets the Grapes of Wrath when Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. Corey helped the team complete a perfect third round, and their total is now up to $3,000. But the final challenge could bring in another $1,000. The rules remain the same. The contestant who draws the skull and crossbones is punished, and his teammates must stay quiet.
Final round. The challenge is worth $1,000. But keep in mind, silence. Finish the game.
The contestant must be shot by a gun loaded with grapes.
Emerged victorious.
Ben's fruit shooting ends the day in a big way. They earn another $1,000 for a grand total of $4,000. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library and you won some cash, $667 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
Zurukazama, this is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Alex. August. Brandon. Derek. Corey. And Harshit. Six friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each challenge is worth $300. And don't forget, silence.
The contestant must withstand a barrage of gunpowder poppers.
Accept that. The money's yours.
Derek withstood the assault, and his team takes the money. $300 is now theirs. The contestant must wear a mask filled with the odors of sardines, rotten cheese, and dog food for 15 seconds.
Too rowdy. You lose.
The team made too much noise, so their total remains at $300. The contestant must allow his teammates to pluck a nose hair from each nostril.
can't deny you that one.
The team pulls out a win and grabs another $300, putting the total at $600. Up next, Corey tries out the world's worst cotton candy, and Derek snaps to attention. When Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. Today's team has won two of the first three challenges, despite some pain along the way. They head into round two with $600. As always, whoever gets stuck with the skull and crossbones gets punished, and they're playing as a team.
Round two. The challenges are now worth $400 each. But remember, silence. Begin.
The contestant has 20 seconds to eat cotton candy made with cayenne pepper, chili powder, and other strong spices. The spicy cotton candy and his team takes the cash. They earn another $400, bringing their total to $1,000. The contestant must wear a bra that inflates until explosion.
Humiliation has led to success.
Yes. Corey is on a roll. The team gets another $400 for a total of $1,400. The contestant must allow each of his teammates to snap a rubber band on his forehead.
Oh.
Derek endured the punishment, but the team was too loud once again, leaving their total at $1,400. Still to come, Brandon holds on for dear life, and Corey gets the deep freeze when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. After enduring much pain and shame, the guys have $1,400 to share, but that amount will climb if they continue to succeed. Remember, the player who gets stuck with the skull and crossbones gets punished, and his friends have to keep quiet for the team to win.
Round three. The challenges are doubled and now worth $800 each. But don't forget, silence. Resume play.
With the help of his teammates, the contestant has 30 seconds to put on frozen socks and mittens.
Unacceptable.
The guys were too loud and Corey couldn't get dressed in time, so the team doesn't get paid. They remain at $1,400. The contestant must ride a slick rotating chair for 10 seconds without holding on.
Discomfort and victory.
Brandon stayed on just long enough, and his team gets the money. They enter the final round with $2,200. Coming up, August meets his worst nightmare when Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. The team has suffered much pain and embarrassment, and there's more to come. For now, they have $2,200. Don't forget, whoever draws the skull and crossbones pays the price, and they're playing together as a team.
Final round. One challenge worth $1,000. And always remember, silence. Back to the game.
The contestant must wear a blindfold and receive punishment from a man with spike kneecaps.
Look at the spikes.
You showed courage, but your teammates lack discipline. Fail.
The guys just couldn't stay quiet. The slap ends the day on a sour note, but the team still finishes with $2,200. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library, and you won some cash. $367 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
I'm Zero Kazama. This is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Caitlin, Veronica, Tova, Kate, Julie, and Sarah. Six friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If she completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if she fails, or if her teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each challenge is worth $300. The most important rule? Silence. Begin.
The contestant must take a bite out of each piece of rotten food on a mobile, including an apple, a spare rib, a corn dog, and a chicken drumstick.
Oh.
I'll give you that one. You get the money.
After a rotten experience, Veronica tastes victory. The team starts off with $300. The contestant must listen to a rake being dragged across a chalkboard.
Worthwhile. You are victorious.
Tova's torture is worth another $300. Her win doubles the team's total, which now stands at $600. The contestant must walk in boots filled with bugs for 20 seconds.
Brave, but your scream was your downfall. You failed.
Kate bugged out, so her team suffers the consequences. The total remains at $600 as the girls prepare for round two. Up next, Caitlin tries to weather the feathers, and Julie is pushed to the limit when Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. The girls went 2 for 3 in round one, losing their composure and the challenge at the very end. For now, they've got $600. Don't forget, the player who gets the skull and crossbones gets punished, and everyone must remain quiet.
Round two. Each challenge is worth $400. Now remember, silence. Resume play.
Thank you.
The contestant must drink a cup of very fresh grape juice.
Impressive. You win.
Kate downed the dirty juice, getting her team back on track. They add 400 for a total of $1,000. The contestant must wear a helmet for 30 seconds as it fills with the contents of a birdcage.
You forgot rule number one, silence. You lose.
The girls lost their cool and failed to earn more cash. Their total stays at $1,000. The contestant must take a short ride in a dangerous car.
You survived the crash and won the money.
Julie ends round two with a bang. They win another $400, raising the total to $1,400. Still to come, Caitlin tastes the rainbow, and Toba gets toasted when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. So far, the team's been faced with dead bugs, dirty grapes, and filthy feathers. They head into round three with $1,400. Don't forget the rules. One teammate draws an unlucky card, and her teammates must remain quiet as she's punished.
Round three. The challenges are now worth $800. But keep in mind, silence. Continue.
The contestant must drink a colorful concoction of cocktail sauce, marmalade, mustard, relish, and blueberry sauce.
I can't deny you that one.
Caitlin showed her true colors, winning $800 for her team. Their total climbs to $2,200. The contestant has 30 seconds to complete a puzzle while receiving electric shocks.
You solved the puzzle. Acceptable.
Tova's shocking display earns the team another win. They now have $3,000 to call their own. The contestant must extinguish a birthday candle.
Happy birthday Too much noise. No money.
The girls screamed, so they failed to collect. They end round three with $3,000. Coming up, spit happens. When Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. After much pain and suffering, today's team is poised to take home $3,000. But they have a chance to win $1,000 more right now. As always, the girls must remain quiet and they're playing together as a team.
Final round. This one is worth $1,000. But don't forget, silence. Finish the game.
The contestant must face a spitball firing squad.
You went through all that for nothing. Unacceptable.
The team was too loud, so Caitlin got blasted for nothing. They lose the day's final challenge, but still take home a grand total of $3,000. Congratulations, girls. You survived Silent Library, and you won some cash. $500 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
Kazama, this is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Rob. Gary. David. Mark. And Arthur. Six childhood friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each challenge is worth $300. The most important rule? Silence. Begin.
The contestant must be smacked by a slapping machine for 15 seconds.
Oh, man.
Your pain is the team's gain. You win.
Ben's face will sting for a while, but $300 will help the healing process. The team is off and running. The contestant has 30 seconds to lick all the mayonnaise off a rubber koosh ball. Mark's mayo ball was too much to handle. The team's total stays put at $300. Up next, Arthur meets an angry paperboy, and David's teammates make him a healthy breakfast. When Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. In round one, today's team had some ups and some downs. They head into the second round with $300. Don't forget, whoever gets dealt the skull and crossbones gets punished, and the rest of the team must remain quiet.
Round two. Each challenge is worth $400. Now remember, silence. Continue.
The contestant must receive the delivery of the morning paper.
Just in, you prevailed.
Yes. Arthur took in the paper, and the team gets back on track. They add another $400 to their total, which now stands at $700. The contestant must ride a spiked seat for 15 seconds.
Shh.
discomfort was worthwhile. You get the money.
Ben rode his way to another $400 for the guys. Their total climbs to $1,100. The contestant must drink a blended breakfast made of bacon, eggs, orange juice, hash browns, coffee, and toast.
Effort, but no money.
David couldn't keep his breakfast down, so the guys head into round three with $1,100. Still to come, Rob has a close encounter with hot wasabi, and Gary tries the soup of the day when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. As a whole, the guys have done nicely today, but they've been undermined by their weak stomachs. They begin round three with $1,100. Don't forget, whoever draws the wrong card gets punished, and everyone must stay quiet.
Round three. Each challenge is now worth double, $800. But listen closely. Silence. Back to the game.
The contestant must have his nostrils swabbed with hot wasabi paste.
Oh, God. took the heat. You get the money.
Rob cleared his sinuses and earns $800 for the guys. Their total increases to $1,900. The contestant must drink chowder from the boot of an old cook.
Oh my god. Shh. Oh my god.
Impressive. You pass.
Gary polished off the soup, bringing in another $800. The guys are now up to $2,700. The contestant must put on finger puppets and have them snapped by mousetraps.
Purpose. You were victorious.
Ben wraps up a perfect third round. The team wins an additional $800, and they head into the finals with $3,500. Coming up, Arthur's day takes a turn for the worse when Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. After going 3-for-3 in the third round, the guys are on a roll. They now have $3,500 with a chance for another $1,000 on the way. Keep in mind, the team must remain quiet as the unlucky contestant who drew the wrong card is punished.
Final round, worth more than the rest, $1,000. But do not forget, silence. Resume play.
Thank you.
The contestant must stay on a rotating spit for 45 seconds while being transformed into a barbecued pig.
Humiliation has led to success.
Arthur hung in there, so the guys bring home the bacon. They win the $1,000 challenge for a grand total of $4,500. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library, and you won some cash. $750 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
Kazama, this is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Greg. Rob. Jeremiah. Kervin. Wayne and Jordan. Six friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each of these challenges are worth $300. But most importantly, silence. Begin.
The contestant is blindfolded as unknown objects, such as sardines, a squid, and a hairy lollipop, are placed on his tongue.
Hold it out, hold it out.
Thank you.
bravery was undermined by your team's rowdiness. Fail.
Kervin has nothing to show for the terrible taste test. The team's total remains at zero. The contestant must eat away at meat suspenders until they cause the pants to fall.
Nauseating, humiliating, and successful.
Both Greg and his team finally taste victory, ending the round with a total of $300. Up next, Greg hits the gym for a shocking workout, and Wayne goes all out for a snack. When Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. Greg managed to eat his way to victory in round one, and the team now has a total of $300. Don't forget, the player who gets the skull and crossbones gets punished, and everyone must remain quiet.
Round two. Now the challenges are worth $400 each. But remember, silence. Continue.
The contestant must shock himself repeatedly by using an electrified rowing machine for 20 seconds.
Too much noise. You have failed.
Greg lost his cool, and the team misses out. Their total stays put at $300.
Thank you.
The contestant has 30 seconds to eat a full portion of burnt popcorn.
Persistence was impressive. You win.
Jeremiah ate his way to another 400 for the team. Their winnings climbed to $700. The contestant must catch 5 dangling chocolates in 30 seconds.
What?
You did not complete the challenge. Fail.
Wayne went for it, but time ran out, causing the team to lose once again. They head into the next round with $700. Still to come, Rob eats his words and then plays a carnival game from hell when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. The guys have been stretched to the limit, and so far they've only got $700. But in round 3, they could make a big move. As always, the contestant who draws the skull and crossbones gets punished, and they're playing together as a team.
Round 3, the challenges are now double, $800. But remember, silence. Round 3.
The contestant must play an unfortunate game of cricket.
Oh, my God.
Your pain equals success.
Jeremiah's public smacking gets the team back on track. They earn another $800 for a total of $1,500. The contestant has 45 seconds to eat an exam book made from edible paper.
You have passed the test.
Rob ate the book, and his team wins two in a row. Their total climbs to $2,300. The contestant must stand above a carnival game and suffer the consequences.
That time, you earned the money.
Rob's big pain is worth big money. The team wins another $800, and they head into the final round with $3,100 in the bank. Coming up, Jordan's underpants take flight when Silent Library returns. With the final round of Silent Library. The guys made it through a painful but successful round three and now stand to win at least $3,100. But there's an extra $1,000 still out there if they can end the day on a high note. As always, the skull and crossbones means that you're getting punished and everyone must stay quiet.
Final round. The challenge is worth $1,000. But do not forget, silence. Continue.
The contestant must receive the most atomic of wedgies.
Has led to victory.
Jordan's wedgie was worthwhile. The guys add another $1,000 for a grand total of $4,100. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library and you won some cash. $684 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
Kazama. This is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Dave. Dwayne. Rob. Virgil, Patrick, and Ryan. Six friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. These first challenges are worth $300 each. Most important rule, silence. Begin.
The contestant has 20 seconds to eat cotton candy made with cayenne pepper, chili powder, and other strong spices.
Wow.
Your ordeal is worthwhile. You pass.
Patrick's spicy cotton candy helps the team taste victory. They earn $300 to start the game. The contestant must come face to face with a foul-smelling whoopee cushion.
Technically, that passes.
Ryan smelt it, and the team is dealt a victory. They now have $600 as their total. The contestant must keep two live gerbils in his underpants for 30 seconds.
You were brave, but your team was too loud. Fail.
Rob completely lost it, so the team's winning streak comes to an end. They wrap up round one with $600. Up next, Dave bugs out, and Patrick learns the downside of wearing a bra when Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. Today's team started off strong, but a pair of gerbils kept them from first round perfection. After going 2 for 3, they head into the second round with $600. As always, the entire team must remain quiet, as the contestant who draws the skull and crossbones is punished.
Round two, the money is raised. Each challenge is worth $400. And remember, silence. Begin.
The contestant must face the wrath of a samurai.
ordeal was worthwhile. You pass.
Dwayne survived the attack, so the team is rewarded with $400. Their total climbs to $1,000. The contestant must have his bra snapped by each of his teammates.
Your pain pays dividends. You win.
Patrick got snapped, so the team gets paid. $400 is added to their total, bumping it up to $1,400. The contestant must wear a helmet for 20 seconds as it fills with dead bugs.
You were brave, but your team was too loud. Fail.
Dave's friends couldn't keep the noise down, and the guys lose the final challenge of round two. They remain at $1,400. Still to come, Dwayne gets belted and then melted when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. The guys have been doing well so far, despite being snapped, hacked, and totally freaked out. They have $1,400 right now, with much more on the way if they can remain quiet. Don't forget, whoever draws the wrong card gets punished, and they're playing together as a team.
Round three. Each challenge is now worth double, $800. And remember, silence. Resume play.
The contestant must spend 30 seconds riding a bicycle that punches him in the face as he pedals. Oh,
Your humiliation brings success.
Dwayne took his punches in stride, earning another $800 for the team. They now have $2,200 to call their own. The contestant must eat a homemade grilled cheese sandwich.
That was impressive. The money's yours.
Dwayne continues to dominate the third round. The guys add another $800 for a total of $3,000. Contestant has 30 seconds to complete a puzzle while receiving electric shocks. Rob's shocking reaction was too loud, and the guys miss out. The team heads into the final round with $3,000. Coming up, Virgil faces the wrath of two angry dogs when Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. After a painful third round, the guys have $3,000. But they can up the total to $4,000 if they finish in a big way. The rules remain the same. The skull and crossbones means somebody's getting punished, and the entire team must stay quiet.
Final round. This one is worth $1,000. And remember the number one rule. Silence. Final round.
Oh.
The contestant must be shot with a pair of hot dog guns.
I see no reason to punish you further. You win.
Virgil withstood the dog attack, ending the day with a $1,000 victory for a grand total of $4,000. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library, and you won some cash, $667 per player. Not bad for a day at the library.
Kazama, this is not a game show. This is Silent Library.
Meet the players. Matt. Cameron. John, Ben, and Crazy Nick. Six friends, one team, playing for thousands of dollars in cash. The players draw cards, and the one who gets the skull and crossbones must endure an unusual punishment. If he completes the challenge, the team wins cash. But if he fails, or if his teammates make too much noise, they kiss it goodbye.
Round one. Each challenge is worth $300. But remember, silence. Begin.
The contestant must finish his ice cream in 30 seconds while wearing a fake tongue.
I'll give you that one. You win.
John took a licking, and the guys win the day's first challenge. They now have $300. The contestant must withstand the odor of cow dung for 30 seconds.
Your ordeal is worthwhile. You pass.
The foul stench of dung equals victory for Matt. The team remains perfect with a total of $600. The contestant has 10 seconds to retrieve his hat in a game of keep away, no matter the cost.
The sound of a little girl. Fail.
Crazy Nick couldn't keep the noise down, so he loses the challenge. The guys end round one with $600. Up next, Keith battles a hungry goat, and Ben has a sickening encounter when Silent Library continues. Welcome back to Silent Library. Today's team was doing well until Crazy Nick's shocking loss. They begin round two with $600. Remember, the entire team needs to stay quiet as the contestant who draws the wrong card gets punished.
Round two. The challenges are now worth $400. But never forget, silence. Continue.
The contestant must withstand exploding balloons in his pantyhose.
Survived and won the challenge.
John suffered in silence, and the team gets $400, putting their total at $1,000. The contestant must spend 20 seconds resuscitating a CPR doll.
Oh,
Nauseating and successful.
Ben saved the day, so his team gets paid. They win another $400, putting the grand total at $1,400. The contestant and a goat face off. The contestant must eat a pot of flowers before the goat eats his.
You have emerged victorious.
Keith finished his pot, smoking the goat in the process. The team earns another $400, ending round two with $1,800. Still to come, Keith gets dressed to kill, and Cameron must make a horrifying choice when Silent Library returns. We're back with more Silent Library. So far, the team has been faced with everything from vomiting dolls to hungry goats, and the guys are just warming up. At this point, they have $1,800. Don't forget, whoever draws the skull and crossbones gets punished, and everyone must stay quiet.
Round three. Each challenge is now worth $800, twice as much as before. And the most important rule, silence. Back to the game.
The contestant must withstand a snap of his bow tie by each teammate.
Your pain is the team's gain. You get the money.
Keith got snapped, and the team gets paid. The guys add $800 to their total, which now stands at $2,600. The contestant has 20 seconds to fit into a phone booth while dressed like a giant bunch of grapes.
Can't deny you that one.
Matt squeezed out another $800 for the team. Their total climbs to $3,400. The contestant must eat one of six frozen treats, including fish heads, mealworms, duck yolks, squid tentacles, beef tendons, and snails.
That was impressive.
Cameron sucked down the worms, and the team wraps up round three in style. They win $800 and head into the final round with $4,200. Coming up, Crazy Nick attends a wedding he'll never forget. When Silent Library returns. We're back with the final round of Silent Library. After a perfect round three, today's team has $4,200 in the bank and the scars to prove it. As always, the rules remain the same. The skull and crossbones equals punishment, and everyone must stay quiet.
Final round. It is worth $1,000. And above all, silence. Resume play.
The contestant must wear a wedding veil and get sprayed with uncooked rice.
Until you screamed.
unacceptable.
Crazy Nick got cooked by the rice, and the guys lose the final challenge, ending with a total of $4,200. Congratulations, guys. You survived Silent Library, and you won some cash. $700 per player. Not bad for a day at the library. We'll be right back.